Last week we were talking about Google Calendar and Todoist integration. Well, this week I have Apple's iCal and Microsoft Outlook. And that's the two calendars that I'm going to show you how you can get those to integrate with Todoist. Now, you've got to understand that only Google Calendar offers you the two-way integration, which essentially means if you complete a task in Google, or you delete a task, I should say, in Google Calendar, then it will delete from your Todoist. Now, you need to understand that with Apple's Calendar and Microsoft's Calendar, the Outlook Calendar, that's not going to happen. If you delete a task in those calendars, it's not going to delete from Todoist. Essentially, it's not two-way sync. And that's something that's really important, the difference between these two, which is why I separated this from last week's episode. Now, I'm going to take you into these, both of these, just in a short while. But before I do that, I would just like to say, if you do get any value from this video, then please help me by hitting a like button below down there. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, and you would like to get all the latest tips, tricks, and news on Todoist, and there's quite a few stuff coming over the next few months, then please subscribe to this channel. Okay, let me now take you in to my Todoist and Apple Calendar and Microsoft Exchange and show you how to get these set up. Okay, so with Todoist and your iCal or Exchange calendars, you need to remember that this is not two-way sync. So you're only going to get one-way sync. Essentially, basically, it's just going to show you what you have. So let's go into settings, as we did last week. So let's just go into settings, go down to, let's go down to integrations down here. And you'll see down here that you've got view your schedule, Todoist, schedule Todoist task inside your calendar with one-way sync. So you can choose Outlook or you can choose calendar. Now I've tapped on these and these don't seem to do anything for me. I don't know why, but they change color, but nothing seems to happen, and they do seem to show a link, but they don't appear to be. What you need to do is to come down here and your calendar subscription URL for iCal. So just copy that to clipboard. Great, that's copied. Now we can go into so we can close out that, and we can go into our calendar now. And this is your Apple Calendar. This is set up on your desktop, and you can just go into File and New Calendar Subscription. So you hit that and you can just paste in the subscription button. That's going to bring in. Now you're going to have a number of options here. Now, one of the things that I've actually noticed is that this is bringing in every week, which is obviously not going to work if you're changing your text tasks every single day. So what I would do is every hour or every 15 minutes. 15 minutes is fine for me, but I mean, you may decide you're going to do it every hour. You're going to click on OK. And that's done. Essentially, that's all you have to do. Now, the only thing that I would say, as you can see, it's bringing everything in now. Everything's come in. So I've got the admin and I've got my edit YouTube videos here. These are coming in as time tasks. And we'll just go into the Todoist in a second to show you that. But one thing before you do that, if you hit the Todoist button there and you click on Control, you can actually change the color. So I'm going to change the color to red because Todoist is red. I'm also going to click on Control, and as you can see down here, you can actually copy the URL again to clipboard. So there you go. You can unsubscribe, which means delete it if you wish. Now, one of the things that I should point out is this can obviously look very messy. I've got a load of tasks, and in my demo account, which we'll go over here, obviously we don't have too many tasks in there. So what I've got here is I've got my admin here, which is coming up at 8 p.m. If we go back to the calendar, you'll see that my admin is coming up at 8 p.m. I don't know why this has actually come into Todoist, but it seems to do. It's come into my Todoist account, but there we go. But that's probably for tomorrow. If we go back over here, I can probably see that the purpose and objectives, I've got edit YouTube videos. Sure, I've got it here, which is coming up on my edit YouTube videos tomorrow at 3:30, which is why it's come up in the time slots. But that's essentially all you're going to get. You're going to get a lot of tasks up there. But if you tap on that, you can complete the item by clicking on the Todoist task there. It'll take you into the app online, and then you can actually complete the task if you wish. So if you're using an online version, that's absolutely fantastic. But if I go into this, I set this up to do it every 5 minutes, so every 15 minutes, so it's not going to show up immediately. But as you check off your tasks, these are going to disappear from here. So that's essentially how you do it on your computer with iCal. Now, before we finish this episode, what I do want to show you is how to set it up in your Outlook calendar. Now, I'm going to confess right now, I do not use Outlook. It's something that is not familiar with me, but I have done a bit of research to show you how to do this. Again, before we go any further, we have to go into integrations, and you have to click on, again, if you click on this box, it's not going to do anything. I don't know why it's there. Come down to your calendar subscription URL. It does say iCal, but this does work with your Outlook. Copy to clipboard. Now, this may be different on Windows. I am using a Mac application, so this is probably going to be different. But if you're already using Windows, you're probably a lot more familiar with Outlook than I am. But if you go to do it on a Mac, you need to go to Office 365 Online, which I've done here. I've come right here. Sorry about the noise in the background. That is my little dog who's just come back from his morning walk. What you do is you go back into here, you go into calendar, add calendar, and it's going to give you a number of options. So what you're going to do is create a blank calendar and subscribe from web. That's what you need. So you subscribe on there and you click Command V. So you're going to paste that there. And now you're going to have to change the name. So you're going to go type in Todoist. There we go. Todoist is in there. You can add the color, which will go to red, which is done there. You can add a little bit of an item there, which I'm not actually going to do that, but you could do. But okay, let's just do add a little icon, and then we'll type in import. And that's going to bring in the calendar for you. So the import is in progress. Hopefully that's done now. And what you'll see is it's gone red. It looks horrible. But anyway, so this is basically how you get everything into your Todoist, into your calendar. And that's basically it. Now here you can, I guess you can actually, as like with iCal, you can turn it on and turn it off. So if you want to do a check in the morning to see what you've got on your calendar, you can turn it on right there, or you can just turn it off like that. And there you go. That's to do Outlook. But I should point out, I am not an Outlook expert, but at least I can show you how to set up your Todoist calendar. Well, thank you very, very much for watching this episode. It just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Thank you very much for watching this video. Now, I have a question for you. Are you ready to go beyond the to-do list? Now, the reason I ask that question is because your to-do list is never going to do the work for you. Your to-do list is only ever going to show you what needs to be done. And that often can cause a lot of anxiety, a lot of stress, and a lot of overwhelm. What really helps you to get your work done, and what really helps you to become much more productive, is developing your own workflow. A workflow that you work from every single day that makes sure that you stay focused on the things that you have identified are the most important things to you. Now, that could be your work, it could be your goals, it could be your family, it could be your personal life, it could be your self-development. Whatever that is entirely personal to you. But the key is to develop the workflow so that you are consistently making small steps towards achieving the things that you want to achieve every single day. And that's why I have developed my Productivity Mastermind course, Creating Your Very Own Custom Workflow. And I would love for you to check out the course. The course is available now, details of which are in the notes below, and I would just love to see you in this course. So please join me in the Productivity Mastermind course, Developing Your Very Own Custom Workflow, because this is a course that's going to take you way beyond the to-do list so that you start to really move forward on the goals and the things that you have identified are important to you. Thank you very much.